The state director of the Bureau of Land Management in Arizona is moving to California next month to lead the BLM in that state. We thought we'd talk with BLM Arizona Director Jim Kenna one last time about the millions of acres of public lands the federal agency manages here in Arizona. Good to see you again. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you, Dan.
You're moving? How come? What's going on here?
Well, one of the things that happens when you agree to be an executive in the Bureau of Land Management is you serve at the pleasure of the secretary, and the secretary says, we need you over in California, and my answer is yes.
Yeah. Yes. I know a different beast over there, but probably some similar issues. I know in Arizona, the border has been a major issue for you and your office. Talk to us about this, and what kind of, have we seen improvements down there?
Yeah, actually we are. We're seeing improvements, and we're really hitting our stride, I think, in the last year. I mean, I know we've talked about the border before, and we were always seeing some sort of overall decline in border activity, but we had problem areas and significant problem areas in Arizona, particularly the two national monuments in the center of the state, the Sonoran Desert National Monument and the Ironwood National Monument. In those cases, we were seeing an increase in or an uptick in activity that was wholly unacceptable, but is a very, very big problem. So we had to figure out how to address it, and we really tried to do it by focusing on three things. One, to increase or improve the safety, public safety out there. Two, to protect the public resources in those national monuments. And three, to do it cooperatively, because it's too big a problem for any one entity or agency to tackle.
And there was cooperation, was there not? Border Patrol, sheriffs, DPS?
And it has been phenomenal. I mean, we have had the Alliance to Combat Transnational Threats, which was put in place by the Homeland Security. We have seen sheriffs step up. We have seen the Department of Public Safety on the state side. We have seen the Border Patrol. We've seen Immigration and Customs Enforcement step up. And we've seen tremendous efforts cooperatively, focused patrols, saturation patrols, night operations, shared intelligence, and we've done tactical things. We've put Normandy barriers in some places we wouldn't normally think about to move activity. We've taken off over 31 tons of garbage by cleaning off layup areas and listening post areas. And the listening posts are used by the drug cartel to try and sort of direct traffic. And we've seen market improvements. And now what we need to do is work this over a period of years and grow that geography that we're comfortable with how secure it is.
Something else we've talked about in the past is the idea of renewable energy projects on disturbed lands, be they mines or former landfills and these sorts of things. How is that going?
Really well. And I think probably two thoughts here that are really important. One is that, again, we are seeing a lot of people step to the plate. Arizona State University has held three solar summits. The governor's been there. There's been an executive order out of the governor's office. So you have an alignment of national policy, state policy, and then the utilities in Arizona are working with us. There's a coalition of environmental groups that have become very, very active in these issues. We have the potential in Arizona, I think, to get to a shared consensus vision in about 18 months.
So nothing has been chosen in terms of land sites yet, but things are being looked at.
We do have projects that are in motion. And if you look at where it's happening where we have available east-west transmission capacity. So along the Gila power line, for example. And you're seeing things like conversion of agricultural lands, the Agua Caliente project. You're seeing, and that's important to the state in terms of the economics of it, too. There's 435 jobs tied to building that project right now in a time when we're wrestling employment issues. So that you're seeing, and that is a disturbed land as its centerpiece. We will ask the question about should that expand out onto private lands or onto public lands from private lands. It brings up policy questions like should we have a large number of very, very small plants in Arizona or a small number of very, very large plants.
I mentioned mines as part of the disturbed lands that we're looking for renewable energy projects. Unsafe mines in Arizona has historically been a problem. I know for BLM, you're looking at this, you've been trying to do something about it. Is any progress being made there? There are so many of those things out there.
Yeah, there are, and it is a very, very big problem, and it is going to take years to remedy the problem. So we need to keep the focus on it. We need to build as much capacity as we can. We've seen a decline in the capacity on the state side. We're doing our best to try and help with that. We're trying to inventory all the sites. First part of this is understanding the scope of the problem. And what we're finding is that it is huge. It will take, I would guess, decades to do the kind of public safety cleanup that we really need to do across this state.
Last question. You're leaving, but you've got your ideas, and you'd like to see some of those ideas moving ahead. What advice would you give to the incoming director?
Well, I think probably there are a lot of things that are sort of the over-the-counter workload, like the energy workload that we talked about, the border stuff that needs to be in the day-to-day picture. But there's also the long-term stuff, the heritage stuff of what we hand off to the next generation. So, and I think that's really important as well. If you look at, this is a very, very well-endowed state in terms of the community-based conservation lands. We have over 2 million acres in national monuments and national conservation areas. Around that, in the last 2 years, we've had 366 youth get work. And people like Maricopa County are stepping up, City of Phoenix, Audubon, Student Conservation Association, the Phoenix Public Schools. There's curriculum being developed, and it is really exciting.
Well, good luck in California. Thanks so much for the work you've done here, and thanks for joining us tonight on Horizon.
Thank you, Ted.